Humans and birds are obviously quite different, but have you ever thought about how a bird breathes? You'd rightly assume that birds inhale and exhale, but the mechanism that uses air to oxygenate blood in birds is very different. First off, let's talk about why there is a need for this difference. Most birds are extremely active animals, and therefore require a highly efficient method for delivering oxygen to their blood. Otherwise, they would not be able to sustain flight for long periods of time. If birds were to have the same system as humans, there would be periods of time where the lungs were either empty or holding on to air that has already undergone gas exchange and would need to be removed from the body. To avoid these periods without oxygenated air, your standard run-of-the-mill bird of flight uses unidirectional airflow. At the beginning, we said it was right to assume that birds inhale and exhale. So what does unidirectional mean? I'll explain exactly how everything fits together in a minute, but unidirectional just means that air flows over the lungs in one direction, and this is achieved by the use of air sacs. So what's an air sac? In general, air sacs are pouches in the respiratory system that are constantly filled with air. So whereas mammals generally have a set of balloon-like lungs that inflate and deflate, birds' posterior and anterior air sacs inflate and deflate, and the bird's lung remains at a constant size. So how do these constantly filled air sacs, a non-inflatable lung, and unidirectional airflow all come together and actually make a coherent respiratory system? Let's look at one bird breath. Initially, the bird pushes its sternum out to create a negative pressure zone in order to inhale air into the posterior air sacs. Then muscles contract to force air out of the posterior air sacs and through the lung. The bird then inhales again, which both refills the posterior air sacs and pulls the air moving through the lung to the anterior air sacs. Upon a second exhalation, air is moved from the anterior air sacs out of the body, and the air from the posterior air sacs begin their path through the lung. So a single bird's breath takes 4 steps, and that's very different from a mammal's 2. And that's pretty cool. Anyhow, that's it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, go ahead and subscribe for more videos. If there's any subject area you'd like to hear more about, make sure you take the poll. And as always, I'm Nathan, this is Chalk, and I will see you next time.